don't stop.
What it do, what it do?
DJ, don't stop. DJ, don't stop.
Yeah. Let's see how we gonna do this right here.
DJ Don't Stop.
What's up? What's up? This is your girl, Miss DJ Don't Stop, and you are inside of the Hot Spot with me, Miss DJ Don't Stop. Yeah. What it do? What it do, boo? Yes. It's 6:30, so you know. Let me throw in something right here for you. Y'all know how we do it. 6:30 right now, this particular 6:30, we're going to have a guest. We're going to have a guest, Thea Vidale. She will be on doing her thing. You know, we'll be able to ask her some questions and all this great stuff about Thea Vidale, man. I haven't seen her in a while. Since COVID, she was actually on my last ship with me, and so you know, we done some we talk. I get Thea out her cabin when she's on the ship with me, man. I get her out her cabin. I get her going, and you know, one time she sung, she did some yeah, there we go, cause I don't know what's going on with the instrumentals. Like, what's up with that? What's up with that instrumentals? What's going on? All right. So, yeah, as you know, I'm always doing stuff by myself. Not always, but majority of the time, man. So, yo, I'm trying to get into this groove. So, forgive me, man. So, yo, she's going to be calling in. Thea's going to call in. And when she calls in, we'll get a chance to talk to her. She's not gonna be on the phone, on video, but she will be calling in. And so just know that right there, man. But anyways, the lady has been on Drew Carey show. She's been on Law and Order, man. You know what I'm saying? She's also been on Ugly Betty. She's done some things with Damon Wayans as well. And you know, I'm just happy to know her. You know what I'm saying? I'm just happy to be to know her, man. But while we wait on her phone call, I'm gonna go to a song right now. And I'll be right back to you. Let's go into this, some underground works. They were just on the show. They was just on the Hot Spot this past Tuesday. Trey Lecrae and Burna. So if you missed the show, you missed them perform this song that I'm about to play. They'll be back once they drop some more songs. You know what I'm saying? They also have blowed up in the south side of Atlanta. They're just getting things going to be blowed up all around Atlanta and surrounding areas and so on and so forth. So let me throw in Trey Lecrae and Burna with Locked In right here on the Woo Radio and the Hot Spot with your girl, Miss DJ Don't Stop.
Locked in, locked in, locked in, locked in, locked in. Tell him money chosen for real. Niggas say he got a problem. He did. Brody, you don't really want it. I got a budget on the shooter. Burn a C dot, they on speed dial. I had to switch up my lifestyle. I was down broke, but I'm back now. Nigga, now rich a fuck friend. Got rid of my ass, I can't love again. My cousin, he back in the trap again. He about to run up a check again. Fuck it, I'm placing the bet again. I got my foot on their neck again. Ain't no more losing, it's time to win. I'm built for this shit, I was born to win. I feel like a warrior. I feel like I'm Hercules. I think that I'm Spartacus. Don't get me started in here. All of my niggas in here. Got a few killers in here. Standing strong on my pivot. A nigga gotta move different. Locked in, locked in, locked in, locked in, locked in.
Catching these plays, and my nigga gon' bust you by day. I'm locked in with the murders and J's. If you want Andy, gon' find where you stay. I'm locked in and I'm loaded. See that what you want like you Tony. Half of you niggas is phony, so I keep me a big, call me Jody. Money, power, respect. Nigga play me, get hit with a tick. Bitch, give me throw for that chick. If you don't swallow, who next? I'm taking over the game. I want the money, not fame. I shoot my shot like dang, and I don't miss a three shots to your brain. Fuck them up, I walk around my semi tuck. Niggas gon' jump like it's double dutch. Playing games so we can get them touched. Yeah, fuck them up, I walk around my semi tuck. Niggas gon' jump like it's double dutch. Playing games so we can get them touched. I'm locked in.
Locked in, locked in, locked in, locked in.
Yeah, that's Trey Lecrae and Burna with Locked In. Yeah, I like that. Trey Lecrae and Burna. Yo, here goes a throwback right here. Alexis Renee with Panamera. I can see you. Yo, it's some background to this song right here. I was actually her DJ when she did this song at South by Southwest. And so, yo, this song was blowing up. She has some new songs out. And speaking of Alexis Renee, I need you to come back on here, man. It is time to get you back on the show. And this show is live, man. You know what I'm saying? Alexis Renee, I know you doing your podcast too, but I need you on this podcast, man. You know what I'm saying? Here we go.
Tell them stand in line, baby, I feel your pain. Five stars in a hotel, just lay up. Four court, no pressure, I just lay up. Niggas always talking about they cake up. I bet Big Bang take Lil Bank, your weight up. Yeah, I did it for the town, had a convo with the OGs. People said I changed, I should turn back to the old me. I say that they lame, man, them folk don't even know me. I would not explain what it is. I'm drippin', sauce on, I'm drippin'. No ragu, I'm bad news, I told y'all I'm different. You can get mad and go, hey. That shit don't matter to me.
Yeah, pay attention. Pay attention. Pay attention. Yeah, this is Alexis Renee. Still like this song, Alexis Renee. I haven't heard it in so long. It's a throwback right here on the hot spot. Like I said, she came through. She blessed the mics. She did her freestyle, man. She did her thing right here on the hot spot, man. You know what I'm saying? Alexis Renee is still blowing up all around Atlanta right now. Nothing has stopped with Alexis Renee, man. She's still doing her thing, yo. Definitely doing that. So while we wait on Thea to give me that phone kiss all, yo, in the news, I'm going to say some stuff about in the news. Well, first off, let me just let you know while I'm sitting down, because usually this is not a sitting down type show, but being that I'm interviewing Thea, she's not an artist, so I'm going to sit down and interview her, talk to her. But the artist, you know, when you come through as an artist, I want you to, you know, stand up, unless we're going to do like a long show or something like that. I don't know. But I want to get outside of the normal of podcasts where people sit down and just talk and talk. I'm trying to get outside that norm. I want to be able to. I'm going to be able to move around different locations, different spots. Definitely not sit down the whole entire time. I want us to, you know, be standing up and interacting with callers and guests. In case there's another artist that's coming through at the same time with the artist. You know what I'm saying? Unless I have two artists in that case. That's what I'm getting at. So, you know, just really trying to get to that point of going outside the norm, because all I've seen was like people sitting down. But anyway, so this cause is for me to sit down, and there's no one else working the controls but me up in this thing, because I'm a G. But anyway, so it's just me, y'all. So yeah, we sitting down, and I'm just sitting down and waiting for Thea Vidale to give me this phone call. And also, at 8 o'clock, we're still going to have DJ Los Mix Show on the WU Radio ATL at 8 p.m. He brings the blazing hot radio mixes, and they are blazing hot, man. They blazing hot. And it's a privilege to have DJ Los on here. But in the news about rapper Gunu, if y'all haven't found out or heard about him, unfortunately, 24-year-old rapper was gunned down and killed. And they gave him his funeral at a nightclub. And so now it's like a lot of controversy on that funeral that he had inside the nightclub. And yes, he was inside that nightclub standing. And his corpse was there. So a lot of people was wigged out on that. But like, if you go back in the day, corpse used to be inside the house, man. You know what I'm saying? People used to celebrate around the dead corpse and things like that. So that's really not unusual. Our new clan of people that's on earth. There was a whole nother clan of people that was on Earth before we were, and they did stuff, okay? And yeah, we ain't the only people that sat here on Earth and died. It was a whole bunch of people before we came, and they did what they had to do. And so that corpse being right there in the club, I really don't see anything wrong with it as long as it didn't move. You know what I'm saying? If it moved and said some words, then we'll be really shitting bricks, kind of fucked up. But it didn't happen. But people have controversy about that. And, you know, like I said, yo, may he rep him, you know, rest in peace, man. I actually went to one of my homeboys. May he rest in peace. Ero. Speaking of Ero, he was a guest on the Hot Spot as well, man. And I got to get him. Well, I got to get his music so I can play his music. But may he rest in peace as well. But I got his shirt so I can show you guys, you know what I'm saying? I did all my things I needed to do to keep Ero alive and his music alive, which his family going to do that anyways. But they actually did his repast in a nightclub. It was like at 3 o'clock p.m. We in the nightclub like it's 3 a.m., you know, giving this man his love, his props, and his respects for his repast. It was food. It was music. It was a DJ. It was lasers. It was bottles. You know, it was a theme, and it was all for him, and the family knew. Like, what's up with that? The family knew everything about, you know, how he wanted to spend his I guess, his afterlife. I don't know, but you know what I'm trying to say. But anyway, so that's the news about that. But I'm going to go ahead and play another song. I'm going to come back to you with Trap Girls. These are also underground artists. Trap Girls featuring Swag Jazz with Clappers. So keep it right here on the Woo Radio ATL, man. ATL.
My neck so cold, I can freeze the whole world. Like I like diamonds and you like pearls. Money. I get the bag and you poppin'. Nothing about you could ever be a topic. I mind my business, play the cards that was dealt. Rich, that is, you see the wealth. Rich, that is, you see the wealth. Trap girls is what I rep. I ain't friendly, park my car on McKinley. I shut the city down when I pull after Bentley. All white Chevy, it was way before the Hemi. Peanut butter roof, I was matching my LaBoo. Thing stopped at the light, push a button, then the roof came off. I turned the lights off. Diamond shining, spinning, jumping like Chris Cross. I never take a loss, and that's a fact, cause I'm a boss. I never take a loss.
Sugar, what you doing to my nephew?
Give me some sugar.
Candy, I'm juicy, get wet like Gusha. D or D song, they call me Sugar. I'm a trappin' ass bad, can't name a bitch hooter. I'm a money getting mismatch, what miss pockets is full of. When I tap, that's a round of applause. Put a dog gone for pause. So B, you can't see no draws. I'm a big P, I ain't got no balls. I don't claim, but my bitch, we gang. Time to ride, yeah, my bitch gon' bang. Post on a Chevy, so you know we gon' swing. Bump the ESG whenever we switch lanes. Top back, try me if you want, I'ma hit you with the click click. Tryna make it home, cause you know I move big packs. Wait, yeah, you know I move big packs. Keep it got my body so cold, I need a toe tag. Yellow gonna dime, yeah, you know I spin big bags. Eyes in low like a big cat jet lag. Laugh like a big cat jet lag.
Be where they don't compare. Fuck look like can't spare a bird. You looking mad, I don't give a fuck. Wanna fuck with a bitch, try your look. Speaking on me, just know I'm good. With some trap girls out the hood. Chest, no sweat, getting money and it's long. Then I'm smoking real loud and it's strong. Shining, dropping bass. I don't come second, bitch. I win all my races. You give me swag, and you know the name.
All my life been chasing cheddar. Every day I'm getting better. And they know I never sell. Told them, don't you bring the dead up. All my niggas yelling rare. So I gotta keep a shovel. My family say I need to change some. And they don't know that I've been prayed up. And I've been dancing with the devil. One thing I know, two things for certain, they change. See niggas switch up when that money and that bling came. Now they down and out of claiming they ain't mean things. No funny money, got them begging for the need change. Play you just a hate, swear the life been hella strange. You don't know my struggle, so you cannot feel my pain. All that talking on the neck, gon' get your back space. I'm a silverback gorilla, they gon' need a back brace. And all these niggas coochie or somebody ask me. I'ma walk them down, cause I ain't good at track me. Really, I'ma cash cow, swear to God I hate beat. I'ma show them how I move if a nigga play with me. Nigga shot at me and miss, I gotta counsel me. A nigga seen a lot and done a lot, but you can't counsel all my feelings. Bringing up my name, man, it should be counsel to these niggas. Hustle hard and run it up, my money looking like some pillars. All my life I've been the villain, I can never play the villain. Smoking, drinking with the thugs, putting work in with the killers. Always been the outsider, I can never play the middle. I want in on everything, even if you sell a nickel. Stacking mine to the ceiling, throwing yours at the stripper. Trying to duplicate the style when they know I do it bigger. In the field with the stripes and they knowing I'm official. In the field with chasing cheddar. Every day I'm getting better. And they know I never sell. Told them, don't you bring the dead up. All my niggas yelling rare. So I gotta keep a shovel. My family say I need to change some. And they don't know that I've been prayed up. And I've been dancing with the devil.
If you get in trouble, that just mean you fucking up.
You what?
You fucking up.
You what?
You fucking up. If you get in trouble, that just mean you fucking up.
You what?
You fucking up.
You what?
All right, y'all. You're with your girl, Miss DJ Nonstop. I am with Thea Vidale on the phone. Hey, Thea, can you hear me? We in here.
How you doing, baby?
I'm good, honey. Thank you. I was worried. I was like, man, where she go? Where she at?
I'm getting ready to go on the paradise.
Oh, that's where you going. You about to get on the ship.
Yeah, Tampa tomorrow.
Oh, tomorrow. I thought you said by the 10th. Thea, my bad. I'm sorry.
No, I thought it was going to be on the 10th, but they changed it.
Oh, wow. Well, all right. Well, I know you ain't got long, so we ain't got, you know, this ain't going to be a long interview because, you know, I have another show at 8 o'clock, so I ain't going to keep you. And then I know you got to get ready to go for that long journey.
I'm glad to do it because you know we got something to talk about.
Hey, man, I'll be back on that ship with you next year. I got you. I do miss you, Thea.
I miss you too. I'm just wondering what's taking you so long to come back.
Well, you know, I Well, this is supposed to be your interview, not mine.
Let me tell you something. It's the COVID.
Yeah.
That's what shook everything up.
Yeah, COVID.
And everybody's kind of... everybody's kind of scared.
Yeah, they are. They are. And I got my mom and them.
I understand it.
Mm-hmm. How is it on the ships now? How's the crowd?
They're good. They're fun.
Okay.
And they're ready to be out.
They are.
Yeah, they're tired of being in, you know, the pandemic, I mean, it's taken a lot out of people.
Yeah, it has.
And they're not sure of everything. The majority of people will wear a face mask. The crew members must wear a face mask when they're amongst the passengers and stuff. We're not allowed in the crew area. No, we're not allowed in the crew area.
Who is we? The comedians or the crew?
The
entertainment.
Uh-huh.
Now I heard.
So how
are you living on there? How is it, you know, these months that you've been on there?
Oh, on some ships, some ships you get a guest cabin is what I would prefer, and so would the other comic.
And then
sometimes you get a crew cabin if you're on the larger ship.
Oh.
On the Paradise in years.
Okay.
So what did you do?
So I want everyone to know that this is Thea Vidale, man. Y'all know Thea. She was our first black female comedian to have her own show that's named after her. Thea has been a comedian over 20 years. How long have you been doing this, actually?
35
years gone, Thea. Now, it's not a lot of black females been doing it that long like you, Thea. And, you know, I want to commend you. And you are so sweet. If no one has ever met you, you are so sweet. You're one of the sweetest people, and you're humble.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
As you know, I try to be.
Yeah, you know, you say what again?
It's hard because, you know, like people think that this is an easy job. It's not easy. You know, this is is a lot of work, a lot of focus.
Yeah.
And it's a job. But it's my favorite job. It's my passion. I love the audiences. I'm grateful that they showed up.
Yeah. Because
they didn't have
Yeah.
In lieu of everything that's been going through in this country.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So when everybody shows up and they want to have a good time, it just makes it so much better for everybody. You know, the comedians are glad that they came. The energy is so different, you know, from them being housed up and not being able to get out.
Yeah.
So now they're out and they're having a good time and they're determined to have a good time.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that's what makes it fun.
Yeah. A lot of people lost some family members during COVID. Did you lose anyone during COVID?
No, but a lot of my family members had it.
Oh, they all had it. A lot of them had it.
But they were essential workers They worked in the hospital.
Oh, okay, okay, okay.
But it was like that.
Yeah. Well, thank God, you know, nothing happened to any of your family members. You didn't have to experience a loss.
Well, I'm grateful that I'm okay.
Most definitely.
And my family.
Yeah.
And my sister.
Yeah.
And just grateful to have everybody. My daughter got a new house. My husband. And then, you know, my brother and his wife got a new house. And, you know, things are starting to turn around is what I'm trying to point out. It can't always be like this.
You're right on that. It can't always be like that.
God is going to make a way for us to be okay. And we have to go into this knowing that and believing that. Because it's got to get better.
Yes, amen.
And it's going to get one. Everybody gets on the same page. It's going to be a wonderful time.
Yes, say it.
I was telling my daughter today, I miss going to church.
Oh.
You know, because, you know, when this COVID got real, nobody was supposed to be in the churches.
Yeah.
But, you know, some people are hard-headed and don't believe the COVID is real and found out if it was.
And instead of going to church, they were laying in a church.
And yeah. But I think you got better. I think if you're older, you need to take some shots. Go ahead and take it. Stop making everybody crazy.
Most definitely.
Everybody crazy enough as it is. Go ahead and take the vaccine and live your life.
Exactly.
I've taken three of them. So I guess I'll be okay.
Yeah, you should be. But I know the ship's got you taking a lot of those vaccinations and boosters and everything, so yeah.
Well, you have to take the booster before you can get on the ship.
Oh, every time?
Well, you don't have, okay, the booster, once you take the booster, show them proof of the booster, they'll leave you alone.
Oh, okay. So they'll leave
you alone. Some ships are different. Every ship is different. Some
yeah.
ships make you check you every 3 days.
Oh, okay. Okay.
It's not, you know what, it's not perfect, but it's getting better.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I ran across a guy the other day at Planet Fitness, and he was like, I had on my Carnival shirt, and he was like, yeah, I just come from the Pride or something, I believe. That's what he said.
Uh-huh.
And I asked him how was the mask situation, and he said, well, they just took away the mask mandate, but some people still wear the mask and this and that. And, you know, he said basically the same thing you said. People just want to have fun and get out, you know, and get back to some type of normal living. So, yeah, I'm with you on that. But, hey, being that you're the first black female to have her own show, how
yeah.
do you feel about this first black female being in the Supreme Court, first female Supreme Court judge?
I feel like it should have been a long time ago.
Exactly.
What took you so long?
Exactly.
What's wrong? Did you not think it? Surely, if Clarence Thomas has a legal mind, a woman can have a legal mind.
Exactly. Exactly. A black woman at that. Now, they don't have.
I'm proud of her.
Mm-hmm.
I'm proud of her. I'm not proud of some of the people that acted like it was an abomination. But you know. you can't mess with God's anointed.
No, you can't. And I don't. And now, if she was white, I don't think she would have got all that backlash from those people.
Now, you know, please.
You know she wouldn't have got that.
Of course not. What fun is it in that? Mm. We always have to get the hard, the fuzzy end of the stick.
Now, speaking of the
We always get the fuzzy end of the stick.
Now, speaking of the hard end and the fuzzy ends of sticks, now, Chris Rock got slapped with the long arm. Now, what's your views on that? I know you've been talked about. I know people have asked you that all week.
I have to give you sage since it happened. But so there's been some incidents. Let me just say this.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, Will made a mockery. Excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
I smoke.
I know.
Cigarettes.
I know.
Okay, so he made a mockery of the Oscars after his wife talked about how there's not enough diversity in the Oscars and we should boycott it because they didn't give him the Oscar nod for Concussion, the movie about the African doctor that discovered happens to football players and after they, get bumped in the head enough.
Mm-hmm. Right, right.
So this is what you drive him to do when he finally gets an Oscar nod. And I don't care what anybody says, she drove him. I'm sorry. She's evil.
She's got to be something with them little pointed ears and that little head. But
I mean, I look at her. You know what? She what she did. That if you saw it, I'm just asking if you saw it because I couldn't see it on the ship.
No, yeah.
Wait to get off. So the next thing you know. He's laughing at the joke. I mean, you know, it's no big deal. And then all of a sudden, she cuts him a look. And give me 1 minute, y'all. Harlem!
I got you.
Come get the baby. I'm on the radio. Come on. And so, and all of a sudden now, she at him and cuts him a look. And now, he go up there and walk on stage and just slap Chris. I don't know if y'all know this or realize this, but Chris is not a big dude.
No.
And he's not that kind of guy that fights, and he's not one of those kind of guys. He was this. I felt hurt for him because here he is doing his thing, which everybody knows all the actors will get it on the Oscars. Comics make fun of them. That's part of the fun of the whole thing. And then you come up and slap him like he's garbage. Exactly. Are you silly? Are you stupid? What is wrong with you? And then she said, I didn't need a man to protect me. She just threw him under the bus like he wasn't nothing. You know what? I know what it's like to love somebody that's gone. I know what that's like. I know that passion, and you love somebody, you really love them. And she was really in love with Tupac. Well, she shouldn't have married him if you wasn't never going to be free of Tupac. Because you're making his life a living hell.
I know it.
And I feel so bad for him. And she just turned on him just that quick. I don't need him to protect me.
Oh, she,
you know, but
I hadn't heard that one.
Yet and still, she says that Will will not be doing any interviews until he does the red table.
About that incident.
God, he don't. I hope. I pray to God he don't do it. Don't do the red table.
Yeah.
Stand up to her and don't do that red table, because she's only worried about her making bank.
Exactly.
She's not worried about him at all. And they show clips of her and how she treats him at home. And I don't care. I feel in her face. You's a dirty piece of work. And I hope you don't think God can't get you. We damn sure can. Because you can't do it. It's like she's sabotaging him. Like she's just sitting there and trying to slowly destroy him.
And he
take
just...
his soul away from him.
Ooh-wee.
I mean, I'm sorry. That's what I saw. I don't know what everybody else saw. That's what I saw.
Yeah, there's a lot of people said the same thing. Saying the same thing that you're saying.
You should never let people know that you're that evil. You should never let people know that that's evil. But too late, we already see it.
But do you,
we got it.
But do you think she told him to go up there and slap him? Go slap the shit out of him? Or she just probably told him handle that?
Did.
Yeah.
She, did you see the way she looked at him after slapping?
Yeah. Yeah. She gave him like one of those mama looks. Yeah, that mama look like I wish you would do something.
She gave him the eye. You know, like, I know you're not laughing. But she's so evil. She's so evil. She's like that girl, why did I get married? I mean, not her. I'm thinking about Tyler Perry's movie.
Yeah, yeah.
Even when Michael says, you are so evil. Like he just woke up to that. I just want him not to be hurt. I don't know if Will's mama's around or what, but somebody step in and do something.
Yeah.
Somebody step up and help him, because he's here. Right now, he must feel like very much alone.
No.
And then his son gets on Twitter talking, now, that's how we do. Really? Is that how we do?
He did get on there. I heard about that.
Well,
I saw
nobody's
that.
Ass.
Yeah.
You, okay, so you was on Karate Kid, so you just kick everybody's ass. Okay. Make that mistake if you want to.
Yeah, but his last movie, Flight.
It's some real, it's some real people that will get with you.
Definitely.
And how could you say that? Well, that was your answer?
And that was his
answer. Will did not think about the Williams. He didn't think about Venus Serena.
Or Questlove.
And they he didn't think nothing. He didn't think of none of that. None of that. Mm. He didn't think about this was the first time a black man was the director and the producer, executive producer of the Oscars. The first time in history?
Yeah.
He didn't think about that. Oh, no. Put my hand to God. He didn't think about that.
No,
he didn't think about Samuel Jackson getting his first Oscar. He didn't think about the documentary that Questlove did. You didn't think about none of that. And nobody. You only wanted to beat your chest and be like a, I don't know, like you thought you were He-Man or something.
Yeah, you see how he walked away?
He made us all look bad.
Yeah, and he walked away cocky with it too. Like I was, you gonna do something? You gonna do something? And went on and sat down. But
little does he know that Chris Rock got 10 brothers. I don't know why you strutting, because some of his brothers posted that they're not accepting that apology.
Yeah, because it was weak. He didn't apologize to him at first.
He to apologize where he did it.
Yeah.
He did it at the Oscar. Stand on that stage and say you sorry to Chris.
Instead, he went and his speech was more like he was a victim. You know, we have to I understand what he started off with saying, that he understand that there are celebrities and they, you know, they have to take, in my own words, they have to take the bitter with the sweet. Whoever talks to him, talks about them. So, and it was more like, okay, now you're the victim. It's no more of, is Chris rock face hot? Is it hot? Is it still steaming from that hot slap you just gave him? And now you're crying, and now you're happy you're a victim. It was all so many emotions. I didn't know what to say. It was like the days of our lives. It was definitely.
I mean, I was broken. I mean, I couldn't. I didn't even want to hear him speak. That's how real it was for me. I didn't want to hear him utter one word, and because none of it was going to be real. None of it was going to be real because he did what he wanted. And he was real happy and proud of himself. But remember, if this was a setup, because at first I thought it was, but if this was a setup, I would say this. I hope it was worth it. Because I know a whole lot of people that are not forgiving you for this.
No.
Because it was too much, it meant too much. We came too far to get it, and here you come to dismiss it, like you baby Jesus. Really? I wish I could talk to him.
I do too, Thea, because I know you'll put some sense in him.
I was just going to ask him, are you happy with everything? Are you cool? Because you
are
living the devil.
Yeah. Well, now he's in like time out, like they did. Oprah, like they did. Whoopi put her in time out for 2 weeks. So he's kind of like Netflix isn't doing something with him right now, and it's a pause on Bad Boy 4. He's feeling that. He's feeling it. He's getting his little hand slapped, you know. They patting him on his hand, telling him he was a bad boy. He shouldn't have did that. But you know, somebody need to really kind of like whoop his ass a little bit. I don't know. Sometimes people forget how it feel to get the ass whooped.
I mean, I feel like if they didn't do something, I think I have a friend of mine that he would have arrested.
Exactly, because that was assault in front of everybody.
They asked him to leave, but I brought LAPD. I'm sure they would have loved this.
Yeah.
And I'm sure the LAPD would have came in there like gangbusters. They would have loved every minute of it. Because they like to take celebrities down.
You're right on that. You're right on that, Thea. So, Thea.
It's sad.
It is sad.
But I'm going to tell y'all all this, though. We need to pray for Will because he's in a dark place. I don't believe that everybody, no one is perfect, but I don't believe that he all of that angst and stuff, mm-hmm. That came from somewhere else. He didn't just be angry like that something happened way before that. Things have been brewing. You know, you got a wife that got on national television talking about she had an entanglement with his son's best friend, and what the hell? I mean,
and now that situation, right there, that's a lot. That's a lot going on. That entanglement.
That's a lot, and she don't care. She don't care.
And she put it all on her show.
And her show won an Emmy.
Oh.
Okay. But the Red Table, I think it won an Emmy. That's what the talk is. But my thing is this. What she did was evil. And if I was him, I wouldn't talk to her for a while.
Yeah.
After hearing what she said about him, I don't need nobody to be da 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 da. All people need protection. That's why we got God.
Exactly.
He's our refuge in times of trouble. And I think that we shouldn't just see evil in him. We should, we can talk about the evil, but we also need to be open and praying for him and forgive him.
Yes.
It costs too much. To let him get away with it costs too much.
It does.
And I hate to say it, white folk ain't gonna forget. Let people forget what happened to Mel Gibson. When he had his racial tirade. So, you know, if they can shut him down and he was a big money maker, they don't give any, they don't give a damn about Will.
No, they don't. And he did the Passion of the Christ, man. He did, you know, that's
he did the Passion of Christ.
Yeah.
And they didn't forgive him. They said, well, you better look at Jesus to forgive you because you and he was being racist. I mean, he was talking about Jews and blacks and just was going on a, just went all South Park on everybody.
South Park.
And then he said all that stuff and people were like, what? You said what? You must not have read a book called Empire of Their Own. The Jews invented Hollywood.
They did.
Don't be stupid. They did.
And they shut you down.
It was them. Everybody get their little niche.
Yeah.
But he's really, really, I feel for him. I do. As the days pass on, I begin to wonder, are you okay? Because please, Lord, don't let him take his life. Because ain't nobody never going to like Jada.
Not after this. And I used to have a crush on her. Jada, I used to have a crush on Jada. Back in the day, these little short girls wanted to be bald-headed and petite and looking all like Jada Pinkett.
I don't know what the big deal. I mean, I'm sorry about having alopecia and stuff, but everybody don't know what you doing at your house.
Yeah, and she been bald-headed. She been bald-headed.
I mean, always had short haircuts and stuff. You know,
I just hope that
Will sometimes find some way back. But people are starting to come out of the woodwork and tell about their experiences with Will, and I mean Paul Rodriguez, because he was in Ali, and he said Will was not nice to him. He was mad at the guy that was really with Ali that told him, said, that's not how that went. I can't think of his name. But he came on the set and he told him, that's not how that went. And he took it out on Paul. And told Paul, you're not, when he was in Africa, you're not in Mexico. This is Africa. And I'm like, what the hell that got to do with anything?
He said that.
You know, what's wrong that she would say such a thing? So, pretty bad. But anyway, I'm looking to see how this is going to turn out. That's what I can say.
I am too. Now,
No, I'm waiting for you to ask me a question.
Oh, I was waiting for you to finish your sentence, Thea. My bad. Now, Thea, now we are on this subject right here about I guess it's kind of fucked up. So I have a little thing to ask you right now. This is just a little segment I'm trying to put in to this show. What is a fucked up moment for you? In the world today, other than the Will and Jada, do you have another fucked up moment that's going on, you know, something that's fucked up that you just want to just get off your chest or anything? And then we're going to turn it around to something positive.
You know what? I really don't have a fucked up moment. I have 5 grandchildren that live with me and my daughter. I got my nails and my lashes done. All gone.
Okay.
I have, you know, if you want to say what hurts a little bit, not a little bit, but a lot, but the 10th of April is the day I gave birth to my youngest son who passed away.
Oh, yeah, Sergio.
And that hurts my heart. And I have to hold my head up because his son lives with me and stuff. And I don't want them to be break. Give me that.
Yeah.
Hey, stop taking stuff out the trash. And the one-year-old is just thinking he can run everybody. And he runs around here.
He is.
So, I mean, if I didn't have his baby here, I might not have been able to make it.
Oh, the baby.
But he put a smile on my face. And he's so loving. And he makes me smile. So I try to be happy. Yeah. It would be easier if it was like, like if you had a man that could be with you during a rough time.
Honey.
But, you know, just even not to kind of got to be in love with you or nothing. Just hold you and stuff.
Yeah. I don't want a man, but I want the same thing. I feel you, Thea. It's always good to have somebody to console you and tell you, you know, it's going to be all right, give you strong hugs and be there for you.
Yeah, right. So, believe that. I think men are intimidated by me. That's what I've been told.
Well, you know, you are a strong black woman.
All women, just because a woman is strong doesn't mean, this guy told me that I don't make the money you make. You don't even need me. I said, how do you know if I need you? Money is not everything.
Now, money can be intimidating. It may not be the person. It's the money that's behind your name. That's what's going on then.
You know, if you look at it, women need men for more than their money.
Mm-hmm.
Men to lead and navigate. Just navigate this life. Did you feel something on my bed? And be with us and pray with us and hope with us and be a team with us.
Yeah. Some of these women get with these men who they're not. Their brains ain't as they're not at the age of their shoe size. Put it like that.
You just need your penis.
You know.
That can get anywhere.
Oh, you said that's anywhere.
And I mean you think that's your biggest asset is your penis. How about your intellect? Yeah. How about we teach each other something? How about we talk to each other with respect?
Mm-hmm. Now, how long were you married, Thea?
10 years.
Okay, as I know you, you use your marriage, you know, in your jokes sometimes.
Yeah, I talk about it.
Yeah.
You know, we had our issues, but after all these years and out of not really speaking to each other, we communicate a little bit. I keep him at arm's length, so.
Okay, that's cool. At least you communicate a little bit. That's real good.
I gave him 4 children. I think that's the least he can do is be not
Communicative. Yeah, I know that's right. Say be cordial. Exactly.
But we're trying.
Now
he's married again, so you know it's not the same relationship.
Okay. So I
say hi.
I did see that you did some things with Ellen. Are you you're good with the LGBTQ community because you're talking to me, girl. You're talking
yes,
to me.
I am.
Yes. So and I know they show you mad love. Have you ever been to a show where you know the men dress up, the drag queen show, and they do all?
I love that. I love drag. I love to see the men in drag.
Yes. Have you seen one dressed like you? Because they do all type of people now.
I've never seen one dressed like me. I've never seen one perform and do anything that has anything to do with me.
Okay.
It would be interesting. I used to perform at gay bars, so it would be fun to do that again.
Yeah. You're right. So you're just gonna be. You're not. Are you doing shows on land too when you get off the ships as well?
Yes, I'm going to Albany.
Okay. And when you doing that, Miss Lady, Miss Thea?
Oh, stop it. On the 22nd to 23rd of this month.
Okay, I like that. And how long are you going to be on this ship tomorrow? You said Paradise?
Uh-huh. I think it's like a 7-day cruise.
Oh, so you're just going to be on there for that week or...
Just for that week.
Oh, okay. All right, so you ain't going to be on
with
that.
With my anymore. Overpacking ass.
Yeah.
I overpack anybody I know. I can't help it.
But, I mean, you don't come outside your room only for, like, food and your show right now, right?
No, I come out to go smoke a cigarette. I bust a move for a cigarette.
I know.
I'll be rolling out there. It's just like, I'm going to sneak me and give me a cigarette right quick. I'm going to give me a little smoky. And give me a little smoky, and I'm going to go back to my room
and do that
and watch television.
Yes. Now, if y'all haven't heard Thea lately on these ships, man, y'all need to go check out if you got a ship. A cruise coming up, and you're going to be on a carnival ship. Be sure to look and see if Thea is going to be one of your comedians for that time you're on that ship, because you are going to have a blast. Now, she also do karaoke.
I want everybody to come.
Huh?
Why not?
I'm going to bring out that karaoke.
I have my grandson in my lap, and this boy is just, he is cutting the food, girl. He'll say when he leaves me to my bye, baby.
I can't wait.
I can't wait. Really, really.
Can't wait to meet him. Hope to meet him one day. I have to go down there and visit you.
Wait to see you again, because she jammed when she plays.
Oh, well, thank you, honey.
Linda plays it.
I do. I you better tell them. And like I said.
It's a party when she plays.
And they love me, too, on those ships. They love me.
And they have a good time. They be glad to see her. And I don't know when she coming back, but I hope it's soon.
It's going to be soon. It's going to be soon. Well, honey,
please.
I ain't saying
the name of the ship, but it wasn't me.
Say it wasn't. I feel you. It's like that.
And then when I want to be, I'm a kid to be myself.
It wasn't what it was.
That's
huh?
Why I go to my room. That's why I went to my room.
Yeah, you stay in that room too, and I got you out that room. Remember, I always try to.
Yeah,
get you out.
We had fun, but it's not that. I do kind of isolate because I don't want to be in the fray.
Yeah. And then also you did your song karaoke. You know, Thea got a voice on her, y'all. She did that. She did the karaoke. And I still got that video.
Don't start that. Don't start that with these people, because they'll be coming up and come on. Come on, let's go sing Islands in the Stream. I don't feel like that. I ain't going to sing no Kenny Rogers song. Well, what's wrong with you?
You done well.
I'm not
going to
sing no
that.
Song. I'm sing a country western song. Leave me alone. With your foolishness.
Hey, before we go, Thea, before we go, can you do a quick joke for me? You got a quick joke? Can you think of a quick joke that you got going?
Oh, Lord.
I know. But no, I saw, because I was looking at some of your old videos on YouTube and stuff, and I ran across this video about the sucking dick, save a life. I mean, you know, it's a quick.
I think every woman that has a good man, a damn good man, every morning before he goes to work, she should suck his dick. Because it's not a bad thing, it's a good thing. It makes him happy. It eases his tension. He's even nice to the neighbor he can't stand. Hey, Bob, got my dick sucked. You don't know nothing about that. And it cuts down on road rage. So, suck a dick, save a life.
Suck a dick, save a life. That's Thea Vidale right there, man. I do thank you for calling, Thea. I really do appreciate you.
No problem. I'm glad to do it.
Man, you know what?
I wish it was quieter.
No, he's good. I like the babies in the background. I like, you know, that let us know that, hey, you a person. You still got things going on, honey. There's nothing wrong with that.
I do. And, you know, let me tell you something. Whenever we had punishment this week and people had to get punished because they didn't want to do what they're supposed to do. And then I got people's phones in my room because they don't know how to act. So that kind of, we ramrodding over here.
Oh, okay then. Okay.
But I love it. I love them. And yeah. I found my glasses while I was talking to you. That's amazing. Because I couldn't find them.
And see, look.
And I can never find anything. You know why? You want to hear why? Because my grandson comes in my room and he starts tearing up stuff. And I can't keep up with my stuff because he's tearing up everything and jumping up and doing stuff. I can't find my eyeglass case, but I found my glasses.
All right, then, Thea, found them glasses. Okay, wait a minute. I have one more question about something that you've done in your career, being Mama Benjamin. I never knew that because I don't look at...
That was fun.
I bet it was. Girl, tell me about it because I don't look at WWE wrestling. And
Raw?
Yeah, Raw.
It was fun. I ain't never been around that many men that could pick me up and not have backaches afterwards. They were strong, too. They were strong men.
They were strong.
But Vince McMahon said that I was kind of intimidating. And I got, if these big-ass men are intimidated by me, they need to get out the game. They can pick me up and swing me around. They said, you're kind of brash. No, I'm kind of...
kind of a big deal right now. You're kind of a big deal. See you. Hello?
I'm sorry. It was...
Oh, no, you good.
If you would put them up, he wouldn't want them. We have an incident here. So I hope everybody's had a good time listening and having a talk.
They have.
And Melinda, you can call me anytime. You know that.
I will. We're going to go ahead and end it soon. But I'm glad you spoke on that Mama Benjamin because I didn't know. And it's always a pleasure to hear your voice, Thea. And you are so humble. Stop. I love it. I do. And I want you to be safe on that. Now that I know you're going to be on for a week, I'll hit you back next week and check on you.
Okay, I'll be all right. God got me.
Yes, he does. Now, you got anything to tell the peoples in the world before you go?
Everybody, just lighten up and have a good time, please.
Yes.
Just lighten up and have a good time. Can you do that? Can you just stop this?
Yes.
Stop being so hateful to each other. I mean, it's so amazing because when everybody's on the ship, everybody's so nice to each other and kind and, you know, everybody ain't no hating on nobody or nothing. And when they get off the boat, they forgot.
They have. They will. They have forgotten.
And that's what I wanted to do, is just carry that love and compassion and the fun you had. You know, keep that. Stop that. No, no. Stop that. No, no.
All right. Well, y'all heard that from Thea, a.k.a. We're going to do Mama Benjamin, a.k.a. the go-getter up in here, man. Thea Vidal, man, that's my homegirl. It has been a pleasure. Thank you for being on the Woo Radio ATL. You know, it took me a long time to get this going. And I will be calling you back. Just checking on you and making sure you be safe out there and have fun. Make those people laugh, Thea.
I do the best I can.
All right, y'all. Thank you, Thea. I'm going to go ahead and hang this on up, and I'm going to call you back later, and thank you again.
Okay, baby.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, okay, baby.
Bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
You going to say it?
Bye.
Oh, bye, baby.
Yeah, any other time he'd say it, but now, not because I wanted to say it, he won't say it.
Oh, I heard him and say something. All right.
Okay,
oh, bye.
All right.
All right. Bye.
See you later. Okay, bye. Bye-bye. Hey, stop it.
All right, y'all. That was Thea Vidal right there. Y'all heard it right here on the Woo. My first actual celebrity phone call. Look at that, man. Look at that. Look what God do. You know. God be doing that. Hopefully I can get Pierre one day up in here. He said he would, but we got to see. That'd be probably later on for Pierre. But also, I got some more comedians coming on this show. Let me get back to me on there. Yes, yes, we have more comedians coming. Got some more partnerships. Got the barbershops coming along. Yo, the Woo Radio, the Hotspot is going to be on and popping. It's going to be something going around in Atlanta. And it's getting it out the mud. Definitely homegrown from the mud. All right, so coming up at 8 o'clock, DJ Los with Blazing Hot Radio. He's about to be doing his mix show from 8 to 9 right here on the Woo. And just keep listening to the radio station. If you on Facebook, YouTube right now, download the Live 365 app and search the Woo. That's the Woo. The W-O-O Radio ATL. I might need to add another O at that. I'll do that, you know, somewhere so you can be the Woo. And then we can actually be like a radio station with call letters somehow. I don't know how this internet thing going to work. But, yo, it works like that. And that was, again, that was my homegirl, Thea Vidal, man. Yo, mad love. She's real sweet. If you haven't never met her, hope you get a chance to meet her. You know, we come across lovely people and humble people. Some celebrities are a-holes, some aren't. Some people just have their moment when they're a-hole and blah, blah. You know how that go. They're people, too. So I'm going to go ahead and clear this air just for a second. I'm going to play one song before I leave out. I'm going to take it to Afro Beats, man. I'm going to do this little Afro Beat. No, I'm not going to do Afro Beats. I'm going to take it to Chattanooga, Tennessee, to my homie, Maul the Pimp. This is one of his songs that this is a throwback song as well. And he was on the Hot Spot with it. He performed it. And here we go. It's called My Hitters. All right. Here we go, man. Maul the Pimp.
What's that on that beat, Paul?
I said it, I'ma ride for my motherfucking nigga. Most likely I'ma die with my finger on the trigger. I've been grinding that side out there with my nigga.
Yo.
And I ain't going in, that's on with my nigga. My nigga, my nigga.
Big Terrence, my nigga.
My nigga, my nigga.
Lil Kenny, my nigga.
My nigga, my nigga.
Big Dan, my nigga.
My nigga, my nigga.
My motherfucking niggas. I'ma keep it 100 with my motherfucking nigga. Top down, straight stunning with my motherfucking nigga. If it's beef, yeah, I'm gunning with my motherfucking nigga. Outnumbered, we ain't running, that's my motherfucking nigga. Name tatted on my arm, you my motherfucking nigga. R.I.P. Kenny, yeah, I motherfucking miss ya. Life goes on, still motherfucking with ya. Tear drops while I'm staring at your motherfucking picture. Take a charge, go to jail for my motherfucking nigga. Fuck it, post bail for my motherfucking nigga. See the best of both worlds with my motherfucking nigga. I don't wanna fuck your girl, you my motherfucking nigga. Some niggas 100, some niggas ain't shit. Some niggas hit your case, go fed, then snitch. My niggas 100, so we going a long way. Disrespecting my niggas, get you hit in broad day, broad day.
Yeah, I'm ride for my motherfucking nigga. Most likely I'ma die with my finger on the trigger. I been grinding that side out there with my niggas.
All right, yo. That's Maul the Pimp. I took it back to my home, 423 Chattanooga, Tennessee. That's my hit up with Maul the Pimp. I'm about to be up out of here. Give some room and some time for DJ Los to be able to play on the Woo Radio. And be sure to check us out Tuesday. I have another artist coming through. Don't know that artist's name just yet. I'll give y'all that info. And, hey, if you know anybody who want to come on the Woo right now, tell them just holler at me, Facebook me, message me, however you want to do it. The Woo Radio number is 678-531-1466. And there you go. You just get at me with that. All right. I'm about to be up out of here. This is your girl, Miss DJ. Don't stop. Peace.